Hi, my name is Deepesh Gupta and I'm heading the sales and operations for ZEN Mobile. I'm currently the CEO here. So I would just like to take you through a little bit about the industry and also how ZEN is positioned as a part of the mobile industry currently. Currently, if I'll talk about the year 2017, if I talk about the data perspective, this year, on an average, every month, about 20 million handsets are being sold, approximately, which is about 2 crore phones per month. If I talk about the smartphone side of it, every month we see this is across brands actually. So we see about 90 lakh smartphones being sold every month, and about 1 crore 10 lakh feature phones. So this is a broad average the industry has as of the current year.
Okay. So right now, what are the the segmentation? How things are going on from Zen's part? Can you
See,
briefly
ZEN,
tell?
if from this pie, we are currently at about approximately 4.25 lakh units monthly. So out of this, we have about 3.5 lakh in feature phones in sales average, and about 75,000 smartphones. So that is how we are positioned in terms of feature and smartphone breakup. So that translate roughly, I think, to about 3.5% share in the feature phone segment and about approximately 1% in the smartphone segment. And it is interesting to know that industry-wide, from the complete feature phone sales, about 60% sales of feature phones is of products below 1,000 rupees. And about 95% is below 2,000 rupees. So pretty much the feature phone segment gets done complete sales below 1,500 rupees. And the average selling prices in smartphones have risen over the last 6 months. So this has been a very interesting trend. Although feature phone sales have remained quite stable, and still it's quite a big segment as you might have seen. But smartphones average selling price has also gone up. So which means that people are upgrading to higher feature sets, cameras, RAMs, etc.
Recent times, we have seen that after the launch of Reliance Jio, so there are a little push on that 4G feature phone segment also. So how you are addressing that thing and how you're catering that segment?
Well, recently the phone which they launched, the 4G feature phone per se, the problem there is that yes, there was a lot of initial hype regarding it, but again, the customer is in a dilemma situation right now because anybody who wants to buy a feature phone, their pocket only allows only about 1,000-1,500 rupees. But as we see, that feature phone is available at a little bit higher price, and already the 4G smartphones are already available at a price point of even about 300-3,200 rupees to the end customer. So what we have seen is that the offer enabled people who were feature phone users and 3G users to shift more towards 4G smartphones. So there has been a tendency that people are spending more money because even though they don't understand what 4G can do for them, but because of the hype, we have seen a more movement towards the 4G smartphones per se because they have become cheaper over the last 6 months. And obviously, the difference between 3G smartphones and 4G smartphones was ignorable, right? So we have seen a major shift. So that is why ASPs in smartphones have also risen. There has been a movement wherein people who would traditionally buy feature phones also have shifted towards 4G smartphones straight away. So in our portfolio, we have decided not to focus on the 4G feature phones currently, right? Our focus will be feature phones up to 1,500 rupees, non-4G, and smartphones which will completely be around 4G, right from 3,000 rupees to about 7,000 rupees. So that is the focus ZEN will be having.
So obviously, if you are playing in this category, what are the key USP of this your devices and the in the entire portfolio? So how you are addressing, is that the battery life, the camera, or the total usability? In which segment you are focusing in this?
Actually, if you talk about feature phones or even smartphone nowadays, up to 7,000 rupees, differentiating in terms of features has become very difficult because, you know, it is more of a commoditized product. But yes, there are definitely some niche segments available and certain things which you can do, which we are also doing. For example, in feature phones, we have a specific series called the Z series, right? So it what it offers above the standard features is certain aspirational things which medium and smartphone offer, like metallic finishes, slim devices, glossy back finishes, glass finishes, right? Glass finish keypads. So these are the small type of niche segment which are there, wherein certain people want a more premium finished feature phone, right? So although differentiation is quite hard, but yes, there are certain niche segments wherein there is demand for certain niche type of feature phones. So that is how we are catering to this segment. And the second level of differentiation, which not just as even a lot of Indian players are focusing on, is the service side of things, right? Because the product has become quite commoditized. So we are looking at different avenues and especially service to differentiate and get customer preference. So like recently I've launched an offer of 365 days replacement, wherein we are promising that if a customer faces any issues with the phone and registers a service call and we are not able to sort it within 15 days, we will replace his phone with a new phone. So that is how we are trying to pull the customer towards us, obviously differentiating on certain range of our phones like the Z series. Price is of prime importance because brand loyalty is very minimal, right? So these type of things plus service plays a key element at least in the current scenario. So that is how we are taking the market.
Okay, Sun, what is the online and offline strategy as if right now for the Zen applying?
Right now, 90% of our sales is through the offline channel because traditionally ZEN has been very strong in this channel as well. There has been a very big movement in terms of the turnover share moving towards online in the last 1 year, as people have become very comfortable with the idea of buying online, and also because the apprehension of putting your credit card or debit card details has kind of moved out. So we have seen a major shift, and going forward, we see at least 20% of our overall turnovers coming from the online portfolio.
Okay, so what kind of engagement you are doing it with the online, offline partners and all to promote Zen?
Offline partners, we basically work on basic ground level visibility by having in-shop visibilities and also out of shop and basic hoarding activities. We do very localized activities in close cooperation with our local distributors, because these are the type of things which gets them impact right in their vicinity, right? So you have seen that even other brands have moved out of very big ATL campaigns and are focusing more on the BTL side of it and working closely with the retailers and distributors. So which works across the industry. So we have a very similar strategy which is also giving us results.
Okay, so going forward, like what are the key products we are expecting exciting from Zen?
The main now R&D and development is going in the mid-end 4G segment, because we have seen a trend that people want aspirational features, they want better cameras, they want better apps bundled with the phones, right? So we see the average selling price going up. So next level of focus will be for the devices between 4 to 6K, because as we move up, there's a possibility to give better finishes and features to the customer. So nowadays, because the 3 to 5 segment has this tendency that they want to move up to a bigger segment, so there'll be a lot around better cameras, better finished products, metallic phones. So usually we see that aspirational features that trickles down to the basic segment. So the time has come now that all the trends which are being followed in the 15,000 plus segment will eventually now in the next 6 months to 1 year trickle down in the 4 to 7K segment also.
Okay, so are we going to see any dual camera phone from Zen also?
Yes, of course. There is a bouquet of products in the dual camera lined up. And as I said, there is certain trends which sustain over time, and there are certain small fad-based trends. So we need to do both as a part of the industry, because fad is more of an opportunistic sale wherein people want those things to get acceptance in their peer group. But there are other features which are more utility-based, wherein that they actually get delivery of what they actually want. So we have to keep in line with both. Dual camera is one such thing wherein this is more of a fad related concept wherein people are demanding such phones in the lower segment also. So we'll have a bouquet of products which are catering to this segment as well.
Okay. Thank you for talking to Mobility India, sir.
Pleasure. Yeah.